Hi, this is Adam right back at you. I love these kinds of changes. What we're doing is we're going through cut number 5, which is just called Blues in G. It's Charlie Hilbert on the guitar doing straight fours. It could be kind of a jump blues if you want. Really, no, it's a swing. Swing in G. Not really a shuffle, although you can play triplets. But you have to have really good technique in order to make those triplets sound like you're not forcing them. If you don't, if you're not fluid, it's taken me 33 years. If you're only at, 3 months, give yourself time. Okay, let's back this up to cut number 5. And I'm going to just play a little bit. When I stumble across something, let's hope this gets it back up to speed. When I stumble across something that seems useful.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So we're starting on the 1 chord. Okay, let's talk about the blue third, how to use the blue third on a cut like this. Okay, here's the 5 chord, right? First you gotta know where you are, 4 chord, and back to 1. So I'm gonna use the major third. Okay, so one thing that's going on, I'm gonna cut this back to the beginning. One thing that's going on is this has what's known as a quick 4. That means in the second bar of the 12 bar blues, he's going to the 4 chord. So if you wanna tell a guy in a jam session that you like this kind of thing, just say, give me a 12 bar kind of swing in G with jazzy chords and a quick 4. Okay, that's what Charlie's doing. So let's go back, see if I can go back to the beginning. Here we go. So the quick 4, right? Here's the blue third. Up. Got to say something else, okay? Something else really cool is going on here. Okay, I'm going to turn this down, which is that Charlie's not just, he's playing 12-bar blues, but he's not just doing the standard 1-4-5 changes. Okay, let's talk about the chords a little bit. I don't know how to, okay? Okay, 1, okay, he's going, okay. So he's on the 1 chord, which is really like, and now 4, 1, now he's going to go to the 4, it's really 4 with a ninth. Now watch this, he's going to go 1, down a half step, down to the 5, 4, 1. So that's actually, at the end, it's 1, 6, 2, 5. I'll play the root of the chords he's doing, watch this. Now watch this. 1, 6, 2, 5. You get that? Blue third. So I'm playing real simple now, right? Back to the blue third. Ah, that's a really cool riff, right? What did I do there? Okay, I took the 3 draw, bent it down a whole step. Can you hear what I'm doing? I gotta turn this off. That is just, that's a cool riff, right? And I might goose it up. What am I doing? 3 draw bent down a whole step, which is the major second. Let it up to the 3 draw with no bend. 4 blow, 4 draw bend, no bend. Now the timing, you can do little timing things in there. I'm actually going up from the 4 draw to the 6 blow, and I'm doing it on an upbeat, which gives it a little bit of bounce. And at all the time, he's a little bit subtly shifted. There's many different subtle ways of reshifting that. Okay, let's go back. Oh, man. Let's go back to, here we go, at the beginning again.
At the losing.
All right. How about some octave stuff on this? How about this? Can you hear what I'm doing? Right? It's 2-5 draw. I'm just having more fun playing than I am teaching. That's the problem. Can I just play a little bit? Too fancy. Okay, there's something I love, I've always loved to do on this kind of a tempo, which is work just on the 3 and the 4 hole, and maybe add a little bit of 5 hole, just the 3 and the 4. Watch how much you can do. Check it out. Okay? Jason Ritchie does a lot of that kind of stuff. I'm losing track of what I'm doing here. I'm just having too much fun. Ah. What I'm doing there, here's something else you got to think about. I'm going to turn this off. It's an important point, okay? Really important point, and it's why we practice, and I think I'll just end with this. Why we practice is because if you have a musical mind, and I think most of you do, not everybody is built to improvise, some people just, you know, but some of us, you have that song inside you that has to get out. You have that little whistling melody, maybe that little melody you whistle in the morning when you're whistle while you work, right? Okay, you practice, you know, and why did Coltrane practice for hours a day? Why does Magic Dick still practice for hours a day? You practice so that when you're in the middle of the improvisation and you suddenly get an idea and your imagination says, I could go, you know, imagine like what a butterfly, the way a butterfly feels when it decides it's going to do some wild thing, or the way one of our fighter bombers, you know, a Navy jet, you know, you've seen the moves those guys make. You think of that move, it's actually not that different from that kind of thing. When I improvise, I'm not a fighter pilot, but you know what I'm saying? You're moving through three-dimensional, four-dimensional space, and you're imagining. It's what Jason is a skateboarder. It's a skateboard thing. It's those loops, it's curls, it's what skiers do. It's what I'm doing right now with my metaphors, right? I can't do it on harp anymore. My point is, this is why you practice. You practice so that you can execute the idea that suddenly comes to you. That's the foundational idea of improvising. But that's why you practice. It's so that when you get an idea and you go, and you get an idea of how to carry it through. Here's a 12-bar blues. Yeah, terrible, terrible, terrible. So this is why we practice this, so we don't humiliate ourselves on YouTube in front of, I think I have 5,300 Okay. I'm trying to free you guys. You've obviously figured that out by now. Let's start at the beginning. Here we go. Blues in G.
Blues in G.
All right?
One, two, three,
keep it simple. Davis used to say there's no such thing as a wrong note as long as you do it again, right? So if you hit a bad note, do it again twice as hard. I gotta go. That's it on cut number 5. See you guys soon. Bye-bye.